Simon Blackwell, and I'm representing the personal history of David Copperfield. It's a great honour, you know. BIFA is such a wonderful organisation. It's such a wonderful shop window for the British industry, British talent. So we're thrilled. I mean, the last time I was here was 10 years ago for In the Loop. And it's very, very different now. It's just this level of glam we didn't have then. And it's a wonderful honour to pick up this many nominations. We've been working together for sort of 16 years, and I've known how much of a Dickens fan he is, and we've talked for a long, long time about bringing David Copperfield to the screen, and so it was just a matter of time, really. He and Dickens are very similar talents in terms of how they look at the world, in terms of their satirical eye, and in terms of the warmth of what they do. So it was just a matter of time, I think, before Armando and Charles met and had a pint. The character of David Copperfield has to be Dickens, because Dickens wrote David Copperfield as himself. So he has to have that authority and that spark. But he also has to be able to play a 16, 17-year-old David who's vulnerable, and everything in between those as well. So it's a sort of impossible thing to do, and he does it with such skill and elan, and he's also a brilliant physical comedian, which I've not seen him do before. He's just very, very funny as a physical comedian, and that's some of my favourite stuff in the film.
Well, it's always lovely to be recognised by BIFA, because if you work in the British independent space, then, you know, it's a particular kind of privilege and a particular kind of struggle. And I think, you know, the range of work that's on show here tonight, the range of nominations, is just a tribute to, you know, how incredibly talented people in this room, the people in the British industry are. So very proud to be in this company. Very pleased to be the film with the most nominations. It's very hard to make Dickens as movies, because, you know, I think the audience as well as the source material are kind of used to seeing them in long form TV serialized adaptations, you know, which is how Dickens wrote them after all. So the minute you take it on as a 2-hour movie, you're setting yourself up for a considerably energetic bit of editing work. We always wanted to make it as a movie. We always wanted to honour the kind of tonality and the comedy and the themes of the source material, but we knew we'd have to make some pretty stringent cuts to the actual narrative. And, you know, it's all about trying to keep the energy and the spirit of Dickens going in the film. So I hope we've done that. Well, I'm not sure we sat down and thought, oh, let's make a political statement and cast an Asian actor as our lead in David Copperfield. We sat down and thought, who would be the best person to play David Copperfield of the young British actors that we can think of? And the answer to that question was Dev Patel. He was the only person on the list. There was never anyone else on the list. Luckily, he said yes. Look, once you've made that decision, certain other things follow. And I think from then on, our discussion was really, let's follow the same principles throughout in our casting strategy, which was, let's cast the best actor for the role who can represent the character that Dickens has given birth to most beautifully and succinctly and truthfully, and not worry about, you know, the DNA of it all.
Here celebrating independent cinema, can you talk about what that label means to you and how you feel about being nominated in so many categories at this evening's awards?
It's kind of important. I mean, all the movies I've done have been like, kept the budget low so that we're not beholden to a big studio system, and that gives you so much creative freedom. Yes, there's restrictions on, you know, the budget, and you become creative with that, but it's important that you're allowed to have, and what that means is that you make films with a bit of a personality, you know, whether it's the personality of the writer or the director or of the cast, it feels you're getting something that hasn't just been put on a conveyor belt of a bigger movie making machine. So that's important. So to be recognised by the independent film industry here is really heartening.
What makes Charles Dickens one of our most important literary figures? And can you talk a little bit about your somewhat ambitious efforts to modernise Dickens in a way that I don't think has been done on screen, at least before?
Well, Dickens, I mean, he's always been one of my kind of creative heroes. He had phenomenal output, he had a fantastic storyteller. he wasn't afraid of being popular. You know, his books were sold in monthly and weekly installments. He made cliffhangers. They were accessible to everyone. All classes in society read his work. And doing that, he knew what he was not also afraid to talk about issues like poverty and homelessness and the workhouse and bad schooling and so on. He wanted to engage with as big an audience as possible. So that's the thing that I always remember. And he's very, very funny. Very funny. I could only think of Dev to play David Copperfield. I couldn't think of anyone else. You know, I've seen him be comedic, but it was in when he was in Lion, being very strong and charismatic, which is where I knew we needed from David. I instantly thought he's David Copperfield, and then that made me think there's no one else. I couldn't think of anyone. I was so glad he said yes. He's in every scene. He carries, you know, he's in it for 2 hours. He has to do slapstick and emotion and comedy and stillness and then, you know, verbosity and all sorts. And he just, for me, embodies the character. And that's a true mark of working with a terrific actor, really. You can't imagine anyone else playing that part.
Of course, if you look at the amazing ensemble cast, I mean, Hugh Laurie, for example, I think Mr. Dick is in many ways one of the first and most sincere depictions of mental illness in English literature. Can you talk a little bit about how important it was for you to handle that element of the story and to give it the prominence that the book does?
Yes, Dickens was very, very straightforward and in the book says Mr. Dick is mentally ill, which is not a term that was used much at the time. And it's so easy in adaptations to make Mr. Dick a figure of fun, someone to laugh at. And actually, and we had long conversations, Hugh and I, about making him sympathetic and wanting us to feel for him and feel for his, you know, the difficulties that were going on with him. And also, but also his warmth and his generosity. The next thing is also coming out in January for HBO. It's a sci-fi comedy set on a spaceship. So I'm going into the world, the future, 40 years into the future.
In terms of dipping your toes into sci-fi, are there particular inspirations that you're drawing upon from that in terms of tone, the visual aesthetic? Because it's obviously such a great playground sci-fi.
I like the realism of the first Alien film, and the reboot of Battlestar Galactica was good. I grew up watching Space 1999, which was kind of interesting as well. A Gerry Anderson, live-action Gerry Anderson. But I love sci-fi anyway. I love it as a genre.
Will you be carrying any of your growing troupe of performers with you?
Nikki Mukaboard, who plays Mrs. Steerforth, has a key cast in Avenue 5, as is Hugh Laurie. Hugh Laurie is the ship's captain.
I mean, Hugh is such a chameleon. What can we expect? Are we going to get evil, sinister night manager Hugh Laurie or playful, fun, mentally ill Hugh Laurie?
Can't say at the moment, because there are lots of reveals in the first couple of episodes, so I'll leave it to them.